Hi, Grant K here from the Smoke Learning Channel. In the previous video, you went through the installation process for Autodesk Smoke. Now before you get started creating your own project, let's take a look at an example project so that you can have a detailed tour of the Smoke interface. The first item to point out is the menu bar at the top of the screen. This will give you access to all the basic functionality such as importing, exporting, generators, interface layouts, as well as preferences and help menus. Contextual menus are available throughout the interface by right-clicking at the cursor's location. Smoke's working environment is called the workspace. Since only one project may be open at a time, the workspace contains the current project's media and sequences. Smoke's interface has been designed to take on the everyday tasks you may encounter. These tasks have been divided up into specific tabs located at the bottom of the interface. Here you will find four tabs. Firstly, you have the Media Hub tab for media management tasks. This includes media importing, exporting, project sharing, and archiving. The second tab is for timeline conforming from other applications. The formats supported are XMLs from Final Cut Pro 7 and Final Cut Pro 10, and AAFs from Avid Media Composer. The next tab is the timeline tab for all your editorial and effects creation needs. And finally, you have the tools tab where you can perform a few creative and technical tasks. You can simply switch between these tabs to call out the appropriate tasks. Now, one item on the interface that all tabs have in common is this window located to the left of the interface. This is called the Media Panel. The Media Panel has a few sections, but the general gist is to work with media. The main section you'll be working in is known as the Media Library. The media library is the equivalent of a bin or folders where you can store your media and sequences. You can have as many folders as you like, as well as arrange them to suit your media management needs. Please note that you have access to various media panel settings at the bottom of the media panel. One common menu located in every section of the interface is the gear menu. This menu contains various operations particular to that specific part of the Smoke interface. Since most of your creative work will be done in the Timeline tab, let's focus here for a few minutes. The standard timeline view has been designed for ease of use, and you will notice similarities from what you have been used to in the past. You have the media panel on the left, the top half of the screen is for the viewers, and the bottom half of the screen is for the timeline, which can contain one or more sequences. The viewers can be displayed in various modes. These modes are interchangeable by either using the drop-down menu or using the specified keyboard shortcut. The keyboard shortcuts are usually displayed next to the tools in most of the pull-down menus. All the viewers can be resized by dragging on the dividing line between the viewers. Zooming and panning the image is also possible by selecting the appropriate tool from the Tools pull-down menu. Control-Option will zoom the viewer. And Control-Command will pan the viewer. You also have access to various viewing options so that you're able to use everyday functionality such as Action Safe and Title Guides. Below each viewer is a scrub bar, the navigation controls, and the various timecode indicators with their respective buttons. Beneath the viewers is a menu bar. To the right of the menu bar, you will find the Insert, Overwrite, and Replace Edit buttons. Note that the pull-down menu contains more auxiliary edit functions that you can access at any point during your edit. The timeline display will give you a visual representation of your sequence. You can have multiple sequences open at any time, and they are switchable by clicking on the tabs above the timeline view. All open sequences are represented by the red highlight on their respective tab. The green highlight on the first tab indicates that you're able to see a source's timeline. This could have applications during the editing process, such as adding an effect to an entire source clip before editing it. But for the most part, you will stick with the red tabs to see your edited sequences. The buttons located to the top right of the timeline view define your editorial controls, such as the selection and trim modes, working with sync groups, ripple, and snapping. To the left of the timeline tracks, you will find the patch panel for track assignment, as well as track muting, track locking, and track sync locking. Finally, you will find a variety of timeline tools below the sequence. You will find operational tools in the gear menu, sequence settings in the options menu, and to the right of the interface, you will find the sequence searching and timeline display options for fitting the sequence to the timeline window in various ways. Now let's move on to the next video, where you'll learn how to create a new project and new user to continue your Smoke experience.